Yeah. This album is dedicated to all the teachers that told me I never amount to nothing. To all the people that lived above the buildings that I was hustling from that called the police on me when I was just trying to make some money to feed my daughter.
I am Tohono Alto. I come from the desert. I love it. I've lived here most of my life. All these miles and miles of desert that you can see, I've traveled. All these mountains that you can see surrounding us, I've hunted these hills and mountains with my grandfathers before me. So when you come through my desert, know that this is Tohono Alto country.
Amy, spending a little time to share some words with the community in regards to this film that we have coming from within our community. And if most of you know or not know, I just finished my first year teaching at Baboquivari High School as the culture teacher, filling in the shoes of Miss Ida Norris and Kendall Jose and all the other culture teachers that have come before us. And within this whole year, it's really helped me grow, but also learn a lot more about our community through the eyes of our young people. And I think these young people are a reflection of what we do or don't do here in our community. And to see the challenges that they face every day, taking care of their families, helping take care of their younger siblings, even considering dropping out of school to take care of their grandparents, plus a whole lot of other challenges. But despite all of those things, we have some really, really, really strong young people making positive changes here in our community. And some of those youth you'll see here in this film. But I'm just very excited because from what I see working in our community for like the past 10 years, ever since I graduated, working hard to promote working hard to promote traditional foods and just loving who we are as authentic people, seeing how that dedication comes back in full circle is really powerful, and we're seeing it today. Our young people are so strong, and they're also relearning the value of being Swagima, working hard to achieve whatever it is that you want, whether that's to go to the East Coast to go to college, or whether that's to work at our local radio station to be of service to our community, or whether that's to take care of your family. All of those good things our young people are doing is the embodiment of Swagima here in 2016. I'm just very, very proud to be a part of this project, but also other things that are going on out there. So for the most part, I just want to say good job, Don Optim Nation. Good job, Wichichomichgum, young people, and to everyone out there surviving. It's hot. It's 112 degrees today, but this is where we come from the Tohono, and we got to love it.
So we are.
My name is Jay Juan. I'm part of EDGE. EDGE stands for Educated, Disciplined, Grounded, Elite. It's a concept. Our brainchild here of years of talking and planning and watching our community, watching the kids in the community, and realizing that we had to raise the bar for our kids. Somehow we've lowered our expectation for them, and that's all Edge is about, is raising the bar for them, not only for basketball, but for life. I mean, what they're doing out there in the community, we have to expect them to do better.
Hey, what's going on? My name is Jeff Juan, community member here in the sales area. I actually grew up in Cover Wells and in sales. Started playing basketball at a young age. I found out later in life and in school that basketball was more of a tool to guide me through life. So I had some good experience here on the reservation with basketball. Started competing at a young age with older men, playing in men's tournaments, played 7th grade, 8th grade, won championships. High school, went to states 3 times, Final Four, 2 Final Four appearances. An outstanding high school basketball player 2 years in a row. Basketball actually kept me out of a lot of trouble. Around our nation, there's different activities that are going on, just being so close to the border, gangs, stuff like that. Basketball really actually kept me out of a lot of that stuff. Even though it was around me, it kept me focused in school, family, stuff like that. I got the opportunity a couple of years ago to play for our junior college team here on the nation. It was a good experience. A lot of life learning challenges, if you will call them, I learned and overcame them. I was awarded a top player in the junior college basketball conference in Arizona. Top two scorer, I guess you would call it, in Arizona for JUCO college. So it was good. It was fun. Basketball is not just work. I find a lot of fun in it too. I think at an early age, it's more about having fun, just being on the court with your friends, learning different stuff from coaches, and traveling. Then later on in life, you get the competitiveness, and you want to be the last one standing on the court. So I think it teaches you a lot of life skills on the court for off the court. So that's my experience with basketball in the nation.
Anything you want to say to any of the youngsters that are going to be watching this film?
For you young ones out there, everything in life is, you have to put work in, whether it be in the classroom, whether it be for your family, whether it be in sports, basketball, everything requires work. If you go just 50%, you're going to come out with 50% results. I would just encourage you to stay focused in your schoolwork, because with any sports, you're a student first, then you're an athlete. So focus on your schoolwork, get it done, and then have fun.
Now, we want student athletes challenging themselves and picturing themselves and their community, you know, doing something. So, you know, we're here for them, but, you know, we're also just, you know, to help and get them to where they need to go, you know. With college, you know, with education, you know, we all been through that, so, you know, we're just here for support, you know, but with the basketball thing, you know, you can teach a lot on the court, you know, respect, you know, teamwork, you know, how you play on the court can say a lot how you are in real life. So if, you know, if you're talking trash or causing fights, you know, I don't know what that says about you, but you're passing the ball, encouraging your teammates, you know, that's what we want. We want our kids encouraging each other, you know, we want them passing the ball, you know, we want them to be great players. And, you know, what it takes to be a great player is, you know, you got to know the fundamentals, you got to know the rules, you got to know what you're capable of. And that's what pretty much Edge is all about. We're trying to create some ballers, but we're also, you know, we want them to succeed in life. So whatever they need help with, you know, that's what we're here for. So anybody that wants to come ball, you know, come see us and we'll set you up.
Hey, listen up. I raise my voice, I yell, and it's not that I don't like you. Me getting loud is not about I don't like you. Me getting loud is about excited about the potential you have. I get loud because I want you to do the best you can do. And as I look around, I see a whole bunch of potential. And I feel that sometimes if I don't push you, if we don't push you, you will never reach your potential. And so sometimes I get a little loud, I get a little excited. It's not because I don't like you. It's because I see so much potential. I just want you to work on it. That's all. It's not that I don't like you. I just want you to work on it. And I want you to see what work, dedication, concentration, I want you to see what happens when you work hard, stay committed, and finish their success. That's all I want for you. I want you to reach your potential, be successful, whether it's on the court or at home or in school. I want you to learn to be successful. That's all we're doing, okay? You got it?
Yes, sir.
Come on, son. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. All right, coach.
One, two, three, what?
There's no one out there that says, give me the damn ball. Come on, let's go. Make something happen for yourself.
The edge, I won't back down, cause it's time to go hard and go on. One way up, no way out. I give it all for the family. We stay up. We'll be right back.
Benson. I'm the head coach here for Baboquivari High School boys basketball program. And last year we won 20 games, won 20 and 10, made it to the state quarterfinals. The year before that, we won 26 and 5, and we made it to the semifinals. So we've really been working hard, as you can see in the background, trying to get better and play better. But the whole thing is that really the goal and the aim of this is to really keep these kids in school, keep them focused, keep them dialed in to their studies and to their education, and really keep them off the streets. You know, I think that's the big thing. I mean, that's why we become coaches, that's why we become mentors and educators. So I think that's the most important thing, is our mentorship of these young men. And so with that said, you know, basketball is huge out here on the res. It's a big deal in Indian country. And one thing that we want to try to do is compete, you know, not just be here, not just get the kids off the street, but compete. And so we pretty much play year round. So we got a little summer program going right now. We're excited for next season, and we're excited for our summer. We got a tournament this weekend. And so, you know, we got a couple guys that are graduating, Jamal Toro and Trajan Johnson. But we got a really good squad coming back next year. So it should be exciting, and it should be a lot of fun to watch these guys.
How has basketball played a huge role in your life? And what's the impact that it's had on your life as far as just basketball?
Well, athletics in general have always kept me focused, kept me dialed in and focused on my education, and kept me off the street and kept me out of trouble. So it was a big thing for me. I love the game. I love watching it. I love playing it. I love coaching it. And so that's the key. If we can get these kids bought into something, whether it's science, whether it's football, whether it's basketball, whether it's you know, the arts and crafts, they find something that they're good at, something that they like to do, then they're going to go far in life. We say, hey, as long as they play hard and they practice hard and they work hard, they can do anything they want to do. And that's our message. You know, we want them to dream big.
Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody. Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody. Go, go. I've been in the streets serving everybody. Okay. Hey, I've been in the streets serving everybody.
Let's go.
Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Okay. Hello, my name is Travis Listo. I'm 18 years old. My parents are Sherry Manuel and Sylvester Listo. I'm a junior at Baboquivari High School. I've been playing basketball for 3 years now, going on 4, starting my freshman year. So, yeah.
How's your experience been with the team?
My experience with the team has been good. Here and there, everybody has their ups and downs. Freshman year, I came in and started on varsity first game, which was a very new experience to me. And it was fun, but also very nervous. Yeah.
How do you like your coaching staff? What is your experience with them?
My coaching staff, I really like. I've been with them since middle school year, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. Now freshman, sophomore, junior. And they're good coaches, teach us fundamentals and how to shoot right and everything. It's just real, real good.
In your experience with basketball, have you ever been with a coach that does a lot of yelling and gets his point across with, you know, yelling? And how is that different from what I've seen Coach Benson do?
Yes, in the past I have had coaches who would yell a lot. And to me, it didn't seem like it was really necessary. But I guess everybody has their own different ways. And like I said, Coach Benson, he has a different way of coaching, really explaining and elaborating on us of what he wants to do instead of yelling at us and making us more nervous and just messing up even more. So that helps a lot.
Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody. Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Audrey Ramon, and my father is Valentino Baptista. I'm from the. I'm born in Tells, Arizona.
What position you play on the team?
Position is point guard.
How long you been playing ball with the Warriors?
For 3 years, going into my senior year.
How has your experience been with the Warriors since you've gotten here?
Since I got here, being with the Warriors it's a very humble experience. You know, for us being together for like a very long time, we tend to get along with each other, you know, like taking it serious and a little bit here and there, joking around, you know.
How has things changed for you since you came in as a freshman and where you are now?
Since I came in as a freshman, in middle school we usually kind of messed around, you know, so it's like middle school and you know it wasn't really that competitive. But coming into high school and being a freshman, it's a lot different. Bigger guys and more experienced kids that play all around on different teams. So we definitely have to step up our game and take it home basketball series.
What is your family history? Do you have any family history with basketball?
Yes. But basically all my family plays basketball. So from my dad. My dad played at Tohono High School, which is not too far from Baboquivari High School. And my mother played here at the Baboquivari High School. And I have siblings who are behind me, you know, growing up and you know watching every game I play and you know saying wishing they're gonna be me or something like that.
Knowing that your family and your fans and your community members have always been there to support you in the stands, whether it was at a home game or away game, how does that change the whole experience for you, having your supporters there?
It changes a lot. It takes the weights off my shoulders and, you know, it has me calm and, you know, just playing for the fans and, you know, for my family. Just you know, just going out and just working as hard as I can, whether we lose or not. And like I said to myself, I gave it my all.
I know your uncle Roland Ramon has played ball with the TOCC, Tohono O'odham Community College. Has that experience that he had went through, has that in any way inspired you to play ball in the collegiate level?
Yes, it did. You know, watching him and you know he's playing with bunch of guys who are a lot taller than him, and knowing him, he's a really good shooter. You know, he told me he's had to work twice as hard, more than the other guys on the team, just to you know get open a shot. It really inspired me just to you know whether it's university or community college. I mean, I want to play. Now I am. I will probably give it my all.
How does basketball influence your life? You know, I know that out here on our community, we deal with a lot of alcoholism, drug addiction, gang violence. How does basketball help you from being in that lifestyle?
As I was growing up, I seen a lot of that. And my dad drew me away from, you know, like just being in that crowd. You know, saying not to hang out with anybody, you know, like as older as you, because they can really influence that into your life. So basketball is just, I guess you can say, a way out, because you know it is really sad to see that how it is, like in a reservation.
You would like to say to your friends, family, fans, teachers, your coach?
It would have to be to our fans. Like, just like, thank you, and it's been an amazing ride, you know, whether we lose or not, you know, it's always great to have you guys there, and, you know, cheering for us on a bad loss or on a great win, you know, it really picks us up, and, you know, after we come out to the gym, after getting done change, you all come out, give us hugs, you know, saying good job. And, you know, we just want to thank you all. And, yeah.
All right.
My name is Keyshawn Carlos. My mother is Colleen Thomas. My father is Ryan Stone. I'm 17 and a junior currently at Baboquivari High School. I'm from the Skiptaw District. Been playing here for 3 years now. Going on to my senior year before. Basketball, you know, it's impacted my life a lot. You know, keeping me away from what I see now with other classmates, you know, with the drugs and alcohol, and, you know, a lot of addictions and whatnot. For myself, basketball has given me even more open doors. I mean, I already know for school, there's college and whatnot. But, you know, basketball gives me another opportunity to go out there, see the world, play with other teams and whatnot.
My name's Jamal Toro from Sells Community. I'm a senior and I play for the Warriors. Been playing with them for all 4 years.
What's your experience been like, you being a senior now?
I'm going to miss it. Yeah.
And how do you get along with your teammates?
We're all family. We've been together since middle school. And
awesome. Ever since. Awesome. So what is your, thinking back on your freshman year coming to the basketball court, how has your experience changed from freshman to a senior now?
It's been a long ways. I didn't even know what state was or conference or anything, because, yeah.
What was your experience like traveling and actually going to the stadium and seeing all the supporters that came out to, you know, support the Warriors?
It was good. The first day we left, they kind of put on a little celebration for us after we won the regionals against Gregory. After the regionals, we just came together, though, like, as a team. We actually played as a team, and it showed that night, but,
yeah. Anything you want to say to your fans, family, community members, everybody that's shown support and showing you guys some love? Whatever you want to say to all those supporters, now's your chance.
Thank you all, guys. It may not seem like we don't appreciate it, but we do. Thanks for the love.
Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody. Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Go, go.
I've been in the streets serving everybody.
Okay.
Hey, I've been in the streets serving everybody.
Let's go, go.
I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Okay.
Hey, I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
I've been in the streets serving everybody. Hey, I've been in the streets serving everybody.
Okay. Yeah. I feel like it's me versus everybody.
Wasn't really much into basketball, so I had to get myself into basketball. And it just started like playing normal sports in middle school. You know, I did football, basketball, and baseball. And out of those three sports, like basketball really just amazed me. And so I just stuck with it and kept working. And you know, it's done a lot for me. It's taken me to different places. Like I've been to California, played at the Wells Fargo Arena at the Arizona State. And played at the McHale Center and at the U of A. And yeah, it's just taken me to a lot of places and different colleges.
A lot of opportunities.
Yeah.
Okay, at this moment, all your supporters and your fans, community members, family and friends, what would you like to say to those who always travel, you know, because I went with you guys up to Prescott and I was able to see some individuals from our community way up there. How does that make you feel, and what would you like to say to those supporters?
I'd just like to say thank you for supporting us and, you know, driving all the way out to, you know, cheer us on. And, you know, we're not just playing basketball, we're also representing them and, you know, our culture and our reservation and, you know, our nation too as well. And so, you know, it's a big step forward. It's a lot to put on because I know there's a lot of kids that look up to us too as role models, and, you know, it's a nice feeling.
Awesome. Right on. That's a
today, the 16th seed from Baboquivari High School, the Warriors take on the top overall seed in Division 5, the Eagles of Pinyon High School. Senior number 1, Trajan Johnson. And for the junior number 5, Warren Matias. Junior number 11, Warren Ramon. And the guard, a sophomore 23, Waylon Hendricks. And the guard, a senior 33, Jamal Toro. The head coach of Baboquivari, Bright Benson. His assistant is Julius Johnson. Thank you.
Tonight.
That's me. I mean, you know, my money grown, but I'm so fresh. I pull up looking like new money. Deal. So crisp, so fly. Popping out the latest, whatever. Know what it is.
It's your partner back in here. One more time. Serving it. You deserving it. You know, I've been gone for a long time. Put it down, something special, you know. The game I spit is fat like gopher. Got more soul than deep fried okra. Don't like China White, not like dynamite. Blowing up the spot, cause dude, I'm kinda tight. Got flow fat like beer from cake taps. Slap them saps, big adapts to Big Mac. A seasoned vet, no? Well, peep this man and recognize Mac Dre is a name. I step to the mic with intent to lace those who lack the knack to max that. Slightly heated with the Grand Marnier. Never hesitate to put game in a tight rap. Mac Dre is a name. And I'm like that.
It's okay.
Mac Dre is a name.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right, go ahead. Introduce yourself.
My name is Keyshawn Carlos. My mother.
And that's one thing they try to get you not to do.
Damn, man, I've been doing this for a while. I keep doing it.
All right. Go ahead.
My name is Keyshawn Carlos. Damn it, my mom. What's next?
So,
how did they even define this? I forgot how they did that. I was also as half Pima. my name, introduction. Is it an introduction still or no? Just going.
Nah, you don't really got to do the intro again. I got, because that's what's getting you mixed up.
No, I'm just speaking in English that translates to desert people. Because that's what you said, Jackie.
What? I thought you were starting. You said you were going to hit it off. Am I introduction okay?
Go.
I'm from the Tohono Nation. That's what translates into desert people. It's 75 miles out south. Is it southeast? Southwest from Tucson. It's in pretty much the middle of nowhere. It's pretty cool.